When mapping abdominal planes and regions, which of the following best describes the location of the transpyloric plane? Now, the transpyloric plane is an important plane in describing the surface anatomy of the abdomen. A lot of relations, anatomical relations, takes place at the transpyloric plane. Primarily, it was called the transpyloric plane, referring to the pylorus of the stomach, although this is not the actual anatomical location of the pylorus unless the stomach is empty and the patient is in the supine position. Otherwise, the pylorus of the stomach might lie in any other plane depending on the body built of the patient and the amount of distensibility of the stomach. But that was the origin of the name of the transpyloric plane, in that it passes through the pylorus of the stomach when the stomach is empty and the patient or the body is in the supine position. Now, to locate the transpyloric plane at the anterior abdominal wall, there are many options here are given. First of all, A, it's said that it is midway between the sternal angle and the symphysis pubis. Actually, the sternal angle is located at the level of the manubriosternal joint in here, and it's the level of the second costal cartilage. This is a wrong choice because it is located midway between the symphysis pubis in here, lower down, and something else, which is another surface anatomical landmark, and that is it is located at the jugular notch. The jugular notch is about 2 inches upwards from the sternal angle. It is actually the transpyloric plane is located midway between this point, which is again a surface anatomical landmark that can be felt between the medial ends of the clavicle and the midline and the symphysis pubis. The distance is very long here, so some might use the xiphoid process. Again, can be palpated in the epigastric region. So the xiphoid process can be palpated in here, and the umbilicus. Umbilicus is a surface anatomical landmark, but it is unreliable in many patients because its location is dependent on the degree of distensibility of the abdomen. So it is not that reliable, but it can serve in one way or another. Usually, when we use surface anatomical landmarks, it's better to rely on palpable surface anatomical landmarks, bony surface anatomical landmarks, rather than visible ones. Like, for example, the umbilicus is not that reliable. The areola of the nipple is also not reliable, especially in the female. But anyhow, the transpyloric plane can be localized either considering it midway between the symphysis pubis, which is palpable, and the jugular notch, which is also palpable superiorly, or it is midway between the xiphoid process and the umbilicus. Other options which are given here are like option B is wrong, 1/3 of the way between jugular notch and the umbilicus. This is wrong. Actually, the 1/3 of the way might remind you of McBurney's point, which is located 1/3 of the way between the anterior superior iliac spine and the umbilicus, McBurney's point, which is the surface anatomical landmark of the base of the appendix and the point of maximum tenderness in case of acute appendicitis. The other option C, midway between the subcostal plane and the interspinous plane, is also wrong. Actually, the subcostal plane lies at the level of L3. This infers that the transpyloric plane is located below, between the transpyloric plane and the plane that passes between the two anterior superior iliac spines, which is also wrong. 1/3 of the way between the umbilicus and the symphysis pubis. Again, this is wrong. It is not located in here, because this indicates a lower position of the transpyloric plane. The transpyloric plane is located above the umbilicus and not below the umbilicus. It's option E that is right, midway between the jugular notch and the symphysis pubis. By the way, the transpyloric plane lies at the level of L1 vertebra, and the structures that are that can be listed in the transpyloric plane are the lower end of the spinal cord, which ends at the lower border of L1, between L1 and L2, the origin of the superior mesenteric artery from the aorta at the level of L1. Also located at the level of the transpyloric plane and the level of L1 is the union between the superior mesenteric vein and the splenic vein to form the portal vein behind the neck of the pancreas. So the neck of the pancreas is also located in the transpyloric plane. The fundus of the gallbladder is located at the level of the transpyloric plane. The fundus of the gallbladder is located where the transpyloric plane, which is a horizontal plane, crosses the vertical plane, which is the midclavicular line or the linea semilunaris, the lateral border of the rectus abdominis muscle. So these are some of the structures that are located in the transpyloric plane. The transpyloric plane is used with another horizontal plane, which is the transtubercular plane, to divide the surface of the abdomen into the 9 regions of the anterior abdominal wall, the right hypochondrium, epigastrium, left hypochondrium, right lumbar, umbilical, left lumbar, right inguinal, hypogastric, and left inguinal regions, the 9 regions of the anterior abdominal wall. And this plane, the transpyloric plane, is sometimes it is used interchangeably with the subcostal plane. So either use the transpyloric plane or you use the subcostal plane, which is located at a lower level.